Pumpkin. The pumpkin doesn't know what to do. Come on, Tips. Tails.
David, you go over there. Go over there. Look at your tape. No, you have to play with it. Oh God, does the dog look big?
Hi.
Denise is fading into the background. We will have her fade away now.
I'm studying, leave me alone.
Goodbye, Denise. Okay, David.
Ship broke down in
Wait a minute. I have to introduce you the correct way. Introducing Mr. David Krizak, who is going to read to you his essay called
Shipwrecked on an Island.
That's what I was going to say. Don't hold it in front of your face. There you go. Okay.
One dark, stormy night, the winds blew hard. I was in the ship, dozing off. Then suddenly I heard a big boom. I jumped off and went to the front of the ship. I was stranded on an island. I tried to get help, but I failed. All I could eat was seaweed and salt water. Yeah, and I was stranded for days trying to get help. A blanket of fog broke in. Now it was tougher to get help. After 2 full weeks, I had an idea. I took 2 sticks until a flame appeared, then a whole fire appeared. Then smoke went up in the air. A ship would probably come because of the smoke in the air. I saw something in the distance, a boat that said Pirate King.
Okay, Emma, may I take some? How are you zooming, like, over here? Take it again?
Yeah, I'm zooming in right now.
Okay.
I got you right now, Denise.
Alright.
And then you gotta fade it on.
Let's fade it on.
Okay. Now hit. Okay. Look at that.
Let's go.
Let go of the fade.
Whoa.
No! Okay. Okay. How about you keeping up?
Oh, another dead fish head.
Oh,
Whoa! Look at all the fish head, another fish head. Two fish heads for Joe. I jumped down, I see his big head. Oh, look at his teeth. Big. Whoa. I'm gonna go see if I can.
Who can I see? Mommy, I keep something. Mom, please, let me keep something. Come on, Mom. Mommy, I keep something. Can I try it now?
Can you see the thing you have up there?
Mm-hmm. You just shut up, Mitch. If you stay still for 2 seconds, I will.
A dingbat.
Now may I?
In a minute.
Come on.
Watch a dingbat laugh.
Mom, it's my turn.
We're getting Mitchell whining on tape.
Okay.
Shut the power off.
How do you do that?
Just hit the red button. Hit it.
I'm zooming in!
Shut it off now.
I think it's on.
Can you see the...
Yeah, I can see through it.
Did you press... Okay, did you press this red button?
I can see it.
Yeah, it's on.
Oh, there he is. Look at...
Can I press the zoom?
Yeah. I got the fish tank before. Hello. Following it. I know he is. Whoa, look at his big ugly face. Oh god, his big ugly face is on. I have it on Zoom. Look at this kid's ugly face.
Okay, that's enough for now.
What an ugly boy.
Hello, and welcome to our show, Magic in Our House. Now, introducing our most crazy host, David Krizak.
Hello, everybody. My name is David Krizak. Here we go with our first trick called The Moving Wrestlers. Wait, first we must stop for a commercial break.
Wait.
I am the host of the show, your wacky, crazy host. Our first trick today is, of course, The Moving Wrestlers. Take a look at that kisser in the cranium of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. These people will battle to fight for the winner for victorious in the matchup. is going to be very cool. Nobody is going to be controlling them. And Ricky the Dragon Steamboat is going to do tremendous action. Now we get on with the matchup. As we go into the matchup, my name's Wacky Dave. That's why you know I'm so wacky. Next, the matchup we are going to be witnessing is called the moving matchup. Here we go. The winner. The match begins. Ding, ding, ding.
One, two, three.
Ding. It's over for Roddy Roddy Piper, your winner, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, victorious this week in the World Wrestling Federation. The end. Now we shall witness a commercial break furnished by Kennel Cuddlies. Okay, we are seeing these cute Kennel Cuddlies made by Terra Toy Company. They are very cute and cuddly, like this one, Wrinkles. Look at his cute little face. They're lonely. They need someone to love. This one name is Sniffles. He likes to sniff around. If you are missing a lot of stuff in your house, ask him. He's Sniffles. A cute, cuddly dog. He's nosy. He likes to get in a lot of information. He likes to butt into a lot of conversations. So watch out for him. But he's cuddly and he's lonely.
Hi, how are you doing? My name is Lucy. We are so lonely. Okay, we are going to get back with Host Magic.
Just so you know, those Kennel Cuddlies are $2.99 a pair.
As you know, this is just a mask I've been wearing. I'm a little wacky today, as I always am. I thought this might scare you. A bit creepy. As you see, I'm getting a very good Arctic Chill coat. You may check it out, examine it. Nothing to go wrong as this so-called magic thing. The next thing is a controller. Just works on any old thing. Cable controller. Now let's get to the trick. This thing shall magically turn to another different type of TV controller. It will be so cool. Never imagined. After this trick we will go to the helicopter and tell where the camera is. Where the camera is looking on to us. First, let's get to the trick. First, I shall go like this, and just place it very lightly around it. Abra! Cut our show! And I'll say it again. Abra! Cadabra! Let's have an applause for this. This was directed by our cameraman, Mitchell Kreza. Let's have a big applause for him.
Yay! Yeah!
Very
cute.
Now let's check out something else. Here is the other controller. It was missing. See? Here we go. Back behind the scenes look at News 5. That's where we have that thing, camera thing that looks on. Hello, my name is Wacky Jack, and I'm signing off from the House of Magic. Stay tuned next week, where we have another action-packed series of the beautiful House of Magic. And we shall have the changing Kennel Cuddly. I'll do the rolling credits. Dun, 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 dun,
has been a DMK Productions copyright 1986. Din, din, din.
Hi, I'm Wacky Jack signing off from the House of Magic.
Thank you. March Staccato by Arthur Michaels and Chorale in March by Sandy Feldstein. Mrs. Marinaccio. Maybe we could be a bit quieter so we can hear the youngsters. And the 7th and 8th grade band will perform two Norwegian folk dances, Baby Elephant Walk and Joy to the World. This is Marinaccio.
Thank you. go fast, you go all the way. All my fight is to ride my horse open sleigh.
Sorry, holy night, holy night. All is crying, all is bright. Round yon virgin mother and child, take the last garnish.
There's the two monkeys.
Hey, you fart. Awesome, man. Check it out. Awesome.
Wait a minute. Let me shut this off.
Okay. I'm good.
Oh, peacock! The favorite.
Oh, Bendy fish. Check it out. Uh-huh. Jesse Ventura. Big brown stud in the Iron Sheik. Thank you.
The favorite.
Shut up.
Peacock. David.
Now you can take a bath wearing your watch now, Mitchell.
Yeah, I know what time it is.
I don't know. You said you couldn't find it.
I couldn't. We found it last week. Mitchell, Mitch yeah, and Daddy and I were there at Sears Surplus, and we got it. It was in the box.
Yep. All right, I'm coming up.
Come
so you can...
Mom.
I don't want to get in the way of the camera, Denny.
Come up, Mother.
Mom.
Merry Christmas.
Cool.
Merry Christmas.
Mom. Yeah. That's just bad. Hey, so far I got
good.
Two
coming down with something.
Yeah, I know so far.
You too.
These are all the Christmas toys the boys got. The gift. Okay, be quiet. There's Denise, Sherry, and the boys. Okay, I got you.
that pretty?
Does it bring a camera?
No, we did have a camera. Joe, Charlie sees it. He's right there.
Duds.
That's your turn.
Let me get this first.
That's it?
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, tell them now.
Now. You gotta press harder than that. Okay.
Shut
okay.
it up.
Get up. We want to see the angels. Come on, get up. Look at the angel.
Denise,
how come yours doesn't have horns on its head, Dave?
David Kreezak. Welcome to, as you can see, the House of Magic. But this time it's part two, which means the one that you've seen before is going to be way different than this one, as you can see. Now, this is going to be one on jokes and tricks. Now, first to start it off, let's go into the tricks. I mean, the jokes. Why shouldn't you invite werewolves into your house? Now, I don't think that's the answer out there, folks. Nope, it's they shed on the couches. Okay, after another one of our famous monster jokes, I'm gonna take you to a quick one, which is, as you can see, rainbows like this. Which one do you think is bigger though? As you can see here, this one's bigger. So I know for sure that this one's bigger. Or is it this one? Oh, it must be one of my secret powers that my friend over there used. Now, if I can find my magic wand around here. Hey, where'd my magic wand go? Okay, now we are here ready to go on with our next person. Okay, now our next person to do these tricks will be with you in a second.
Hello. Here I am, Mr. Kreezak, the Masked Magician. Here at work, you've been a good candidate to me today. Now let me tell you a little joke before we get on with our magic show. I'm trying to find a good one. Why did Frankenstein stick his finger into an electrical shock socket? Huh?
What?
Nope, that's not it. He wanted to keep up on current events. Okay, back to the trick. I'll now do the rabbit in the hat trick, which will magically show a rabbit in a hat. Get my drift? See here. Come on, cameraman, come up closer. Turn this around for you. A magic hat. Now, if I take off this magic hat, you'll see it's empty. You'll see the bottom too. Take it off, there's the rabbit. My God, how did I do that? How did I do that? May I tell you something? How did I do that? Enjoy watching this presentation from Blackstone, the Masked Magician. Come on next week, and we say, come on down, you're the next contestant on The Price is Right. And our cameraman, David, who is now going to fade out of this picture, have a nice day. But would like to say one thing. Okay, one thing. Eat your veggie mins and don't poop out at parties. We're now gonna have a special presentation from dance studio. No we're not. Oh yes we are. Oh no we're not. Oh yes we are. Duh.
Snuffles talk show starring Snuff, Grizzly, and Snuffles.
And here they are.
Hello, I'm Snuff. I'm Snuffles. I'm Grizzly. It's nice to meet you guys. Now, this is the first time we have ever been on a talk show, so we might get a little bit nervous. But we on this show, we talk about the top stars and baseball players and football players, everything you can imagine. Now, we're going to have a talk with somebody who is very famous in baseball. He plays for the Boston Bears. Let's welcome on the show, Harry Bailey Jr. Yay! I couldn't bear it without you guys. Now, Barry, how do you like your life as a baseball player?
Well, I kind of like it because I like the crowd, I like the fans to jump all over me.
What's your favorite baseball team when you were a kid?
Well, my favorite baseball team there was the Boston Bears, of course. And I used to play baseball with the Boston Bears. I won tickets to see them, and then when I won the ticket, I got a chance to play when they were at practices. It was really fun. That was when I decided to be a baseball player.
Okay, now, are you going to go on another baseball team? Do you want to be a free agent or anything like that?
No, I'm happy where I am on my team. And right now, I'm just still training at my big backyard. I bought a big whole mess of land. Tomorrow, I'm inviting all the Boston Bears out to have a practice day. And February 21st, we're going to be at training again, and we're confident we're going to make it into the World Series. That's very good, Barry Jr. See you later. Let's have a big applause for Barry Jr.
We will now return to this show after a commercial message from Nintendo.
Hi, I'm David Krizak, and I'm going to talk about the great Nintendo system. First, I'll tell you that the Nintendo system, as you can see here, is the most advanced game system that anyone has ever had. It's way advanced than the Atari or ColecoVision. Now, I'll show you a lot of the games for the Nintendo system. Now, here we go, showing you the games. Now, that was just a test for the robot. This is a brief thing of what this video game looks like. You have to get the gyro spinning on the robot for it to work. Okay, now you can get games for Robot Gyro 2.
For Mario Brothers 2.
2. Donkey Kong 3.
2.
Wrecking Crew 2. Duck Hunt 2. Pinball. Those are all the games that we have in stock for the Nintendo. And now, Cameron, look at the Nintendo system. Here's Rob, robot operating buddy. He's the one who helps you with Gyromite. Okay, now that is all from DMK. Goodbye.
Now we are back.
Hello. Now, after we talk to Billy Jr., we are going to have a talk with the newest member of the Stuffed Dog Association. Now, here they are coming up. The first one is Winkles. Hello there, Winkles.
Hi.
The second one is Nosy.
Hello there.
The third one is Sniffles.
Hello there.
Our last one is Cuddly.
Hello.
These dogs are the newest ones from the Stuffed Dogs. They are called the Kennel Cuddlies. They're one of the most cuddliest dogs in whole Stuffies. They're so cuddly in there from the pound of Kennel Cuddlies. How do you guys feel about living in this area where we live?
I think it feels good. We can run around wherever we want to. It's really fun.
How do you feel about this, Nosy?
Well, I feel kind of great about it. I like this place. I'd rather be here than be in a stupid pound, and this place is really nice. I like going to the arcade.
What about you, Sniffles?
Oh, I like this place. I like to run around and sniff stuff.
What about you, Cuddly? I like this place. It's really nice. These people are looking for a home in the stuffed animal place. If you would like to go, call 1-800-546-2804. They are waiting for you. Okay, now, here we are going on to the next person, which these people will be going now. And the next person we are going to be seeing is... Let me look on my list. Yeah, the famous person, most famous doctor, is Dr. Teddy MD. Hello, everybody. Now, I believe you have a new assistant, Dr. Teddy. Yes, I do. I'll bring him on. He's Barry Jr.'s brother. Here he is. His name is Barry Jr. number 2. Hello there. What does he do for you, Dr. Teddy?
Well, he helps me out when I have 2 patients. I'm teaching him how to be a good doctor. So, if I have 2 patients, he'll help me out really good and give them medicine and treat them well. I always treat my patients well, and I can never leave a patient waiting for me. I'm looking for more doctors too. paid in my association so I can help them out. Because we're still having people waiting, and we don't like people waiting. We like people to come in doctor office and just go in into the doctor, get help if they're hurt or anything like that. If anybody would like to be a doctor, just call 1-900-556-2880. Hello, we are back. And Dr. Teddy, it was a pleasure having you with us on the Snuffle Show. And now, it is a pleasure to have with us at this time our last person on the show. A pleasure to have us, Thumper from the hit cartoon movie Bambi. He moved all the way from a forest to a big city. How do you feel about moving from a forest to a city? Well, I feel kind of good because the forest, we had hunters and everybody trying to hunt. So lucky I'm still alive here. I get to get carrots and everything. The forest, they didn't have that stuff. There's no houses, no people to play with except for Bambi. But I didn't like him that much. Okay, where do you live now in this area? None of us know that on this show. I live right across from this place, really. I live right around the corner. I like to hop around. I have lots of friends and everything. Well, anyways, I have to go now. I have to go meet my friend Cuddly down at Kennel Cuddly that was just down at McDonald's because I need to meet him. It's a pleasure having you with us, Thumper. Goodbye. Now to conclude our show, I'm Snuff. I'm Snuffle. I'm Gwizzler. Signing off from the Snuffle Show. Goodbye.
This is DMK News, January 19, 1987. Here is Mitchell
Krasak. Hello and welcome to DMK News. Kids are going on strike. They want a dollar for every word they write. There will be no school until they get what they want. That's only just said going into the...
Come on, Dad, it's the third time you have to do it over.
This is DMK News, January 19th, 1987. Now here is Mitchell Krasak of DMK News.
Hello and welcome to my show. Kids are going on strike. They want a dollar for every word they write. There'll be no school until they get what they want. I think the kids will be waiting kind of a while because I don't think the teachers are going to give them a dollar worth. Well, if I figure that out, a dollar, if you figure you do 10,000 words every day, and if you multiply that by 956 kids in our school, you get, well, that's another story. Nintendo. Kids are mad because the stores have not been carrying Nintendo games and they've been too expensive. Sega, which means stink. Nobody likes that. Kids are asking consumers when are they going to get the games back. Theirs is getting them at the end of January, tons of toys the end of February. And other news. Let me do that math problem for you. Equals a million of them. Oh god, I didn't know that. Also in the news, Sega is going on strike. No one's buying the cartridges because they stink. No, they're going on strike. Kids are throwing out the cartridges. Here is the picture of the beach and kids throwing the cartridges into the water. You see here, here's a kid and he's throwing them into the water and here's his system. Right here, he threw it into the water. Now here's the Nintendo. And kids are happily playing it. Well, we'll now have a commercial break from Footprints in the Sand. So long.
Oh, God.
We'll be right back after these commercial messages. Have you ever been inside the store and seen a Nintendo set? If so, you have seen that many kids are buying them. As for the Sega, that stinks. Nobody's buying them. They're just a piece of crap. But we'd like to see if the Nintendo is a really good set. You have games like Hang On, Safari. No, I'm sorry. That's for the Nintendo. That's for the Sega. But you know, you got Sega. That's it. That's it. Thank you for enjoying our commercial. Now here's back with the news. So long.
Hi, I'm David Krizak, back with the weather on the news. Now, as you can see here, to all you New Englanders around there, there is a whole mess of snow through Rhode Island, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, Maine, and Connecticut, and Massachusetts and Connecticut. And as you can see here, there's going to be no school, and there's high winds coming up this area. And in Florida, it's very sunny. Most of the kids will be going to school there. In Georgia, it's sunny. Alabama, Texas, sunny. This area, it's cold around here. This area, it's warm. And cold around Georgia, around South Carolina. And there's a lot of snow up by South Dakota, North Dakota. And it is 19 degrees in Washington. And let's see anything else on this map we can show.
Pardon me, boys.
Turn it off, Mitch. Turn it off. Turn it off. This is DMK News, January 19, 1987. Now, here is Mitchell Krizak of DMK News.
Hello, and welcome to DMK News. Today in the news, kids are going on strike. They want to get paid.
This is DMK News, January 19, 1987. Now, here is Mitchell Krizak of DMK News.
Hello, and welcome to DMK production. In the news, kids just want to have fun.
This is DMK News, January 19, 1987. Here is Mitchell Krizak.
Hello, and welcome to DMK production. Today, kids are planning to go on strike. They want money for the papers that they do. I talked with one kid today, and he said that he wants a penny every paper. Of course, some kids I've met go up to a dollar for every word they say. As we know, that's a hopeless cause. Kids are hanging out in a cement building. Just across from school, they said that they don't get paid, they won't go to school. Policemen are out on the street all the time trying to find the kids. In other news, people are mad because Nintendo is not selling their games around here. Parents and kids are mad, but people say that they're not going to get it until either the end of January or even the end of February. Now, as we know, the World Series is coming up, and we would like to know, who do you think is going to win, the Giants or the Broncos? Now, 39% say they think the Broncos are going to win, but an amazing 61% say the Giants are going to come through and win it. Personally, I think the Giants are going to win it. Maybe you think different. Well, we're now going to go into a commercial break, and after that we'll go into the weatherman.
Hello. And what I have here are very nice flowers. As you see here, I have this nice wood stand, hand painted and hand cut. And I have these nice little domes that go over candles. And right here is a lovely basket of dried flowers. Now, I am here to sell this complete set. Not for $100, not for $40, not for $30, but only $29.95. Can you believe that? That is a deal. Now, what this is we at the Looney Lookers factory, we try to make things that will appeal to the eye. This is a nicely hand-graved wood stand, you would call it, that was finished with a nice stain. Right here, you have your candle holder where you have your candle, and you put that on, and you see you have this, which is very pretty. And you have another one, which is very pretty. And you get a basket of dried flowers saying thanks to, and we appreciate you to buy it. Now, all this is only $29.95. This is a great bargain. I mean, like, we just really like it. Now, if you would like to order this, you'd have to call the amazing low offer of 1-800-000-000. Remember, that's 1-800-000-000. And we hope you enjoy buying this nicely product.
Hi, I'm David Krizak with the weather on DMK News. As you all know, outside most of your windows is snow and hail. Right now, it's turning from snow and hail through the whole night right now. Expected to get a lot of snow tonight, during the night today, and I'm not sure if there's going to be no school or not. Now, here we are. Showing you the map right here of this place. Here's New England. As you can see, all snow all around Maine, Vermont, New Hampshire, Connecticut, Mass, Rhode Island. There's a little bit of snow around New York. High winds up by New York and Massachusetts and Connecticut. Now, as you can see here, it's very cold up here, but if you go way down below, sunny in Florida, southern Florida, sunny in southern Georgia, sunny in southern Texas, sunny in about the middle of Alabama, and sunny above Texas. Now, up about South Carolina and North Carolina is very cold. Around Pennsylvania, around this area, I didn't write anything down here, but it's kind of like a cold. Around here it's hot, cold. This is area around. Hello, I'm David Krizak, and welcome to my Upside Down Show. In my Upside Down magazine, my Upside Down Show, and my Upside Down posters, Upside Down calendar, anything you can imagine. Here's the newest magazine in my Upside Down palace. Now, here is something I would like to show you. This stuffy, Sniffles, as you can see here, gravity pulls it down. Now, let's see what we can do on this show. This is the first time I've ever been on this show, so let me see what I can do. Now, none of you people have ever seen me upside down before on DMK Productions. Now I'm going to show you what things look like upside down in your world. Now, first here, let's see here.
See this thing? Now you're going to have to guess what this thing is in 10 seconds. Okay, if you guess comic books, you're right. Now, let's take us to something else. That might be... 10 seconds. Okay. Nope, that's not it. It's, as you can see here, wallet.
We're now going to see what the outside looks like. What the outside looks like when the world is upside, when the world is upside down.
See?
Look at that world. See the houses. Doesn't everything look weird?
Yeah, I've been living in this life ever since I've been transported into this dimension. Now, let me deal with one more thing, then we can get on with the show. What do you think this is? 10 seconds, and you're to get this right. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you guessed the Gyromite book, you are correct. I've transformed it back to your world upside down, as you can see. And now I'm going to take one more. This one's going to be easy. Okay. 10 seconds. 8. Okay. Now, if you guessed wrestling figure, you are correct. Now, we'll be back next week with another one of these upside down shows, so you'll know what to do when things are upside down. You'll know what they are. I'm David Krizak, signing off from the Upside Down Show. Goodbye.
Showing her that, you know, so I got a lot of back from her, and she said that they were shocked when she died because she was in the hospital 10 days, I think. And she died just like that. She must have had a stroke?
Lynn.
I couldn't believe it. And then when I went looking for her, look at you.
Happy birthday,
boss.
What's that?
Inside Greek? Joke.
Okay. Happy birthday to you.
Check for 1,000?
Let me see.
Hold the card this way, Mitchell, so we can...
Wait.
And Bonnie.
I say.
David?
Bonnie.
Yeah?
Hello.
Bonsai?
Okay. This is from Grandma Kreza.
Grandma Kreza!
Joey, honey. Joey. That's right there, sweetie. Thank you.
Okay. We have socks.
Shirt.
Oh, yeah, nice shirt.
Let me see. Hold it up.
And
very nice.
Pants.
And
pants.
Oh.
Let me see.
Oh, shorts.
With the belt.
Nice.
Has a belt.
You see?
That's nice.
Oh, yeah. Those are nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
They're nice.
It's going to be nice for California.
Yeah, they are nice.
I even got the size.
Hey,
Denise, he can buy clothes with the money I gave him.
He won't buy clothes.
I'm not buying clothes. I'm buying...
You're buying some good stuff?
Can I buy a game, I think.
Yeah.
Okay.
And here's a box with half the same things.
And in here,
we have another.
A nice shirt. Joey, please give me shirt.
Oh, that's
and
nice.
And blue pants.
That's nice. Yeah. That's a nice outfit.
Thank you, Grandma.
He said thank you.
Right there.
There you go. This is from Aunt Barbara. Of course.
Grandma's not answering you, Mitchell, because she doesn't want to go on the tape.
The other pants.
You've never had one like that. That's nice.
Yeah, right.
Why don't you sit down so I can see? Sit down. You can sit over there, honey.
This is from Aunt Lynn.
Okay.
No, don't tell him what it is. Okay.
It's a pair of clothes.
Yep, it's a pair of clothes.
A shirt.
Mitchell, you didn't tell them how old you are today.
13. My last birthday, number 12.
Yeah.
Hey.
You soggy.
You told me 12 this morning.
Good stuff now.
Good stuff now.
He's 12.
This is from Aunt
Lynn. Yeah, he's 12. What did he say, 13?
He said he's not going to be, he's going to be 12 for the rest of his life.
Baseball.
Yeah,
What
is it?
Baseball
for
Nintendo.
Hold it up, Mitchell. I'll get it on close.
There's another one. Okay. There's another
You're
one.
You're lighting on it. Oh,
nice. Wait, I have 2,000.
And from Aunt Lynn.
No, that's from Moss.
Oh, never mind. That's from Aunt Lynn. This is from Jennifer. Wild
this is from Jennifer.
What is it? Let's see.
Oh.
Wow.
Look like you have to shoot from a saloon and stuff.
Oh, awesome.
Oh.
Say that again, David.
David,
say that again.
Awesome.
These are rad. Thank you very much.
That's not
true. Are they like rays?
Cool. Hey, look, David. Look, David.
And yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
Yours
and
yours.
Jennifer, don't throw stones.
I just want to see if Batter's Box is home run, Mitchell. He has Batter's Box is his home run and all that stuff.
Jennifer, you won't dance with Uncle Jay no more for that.
Well, are we done with this segment of the Krizak
miniseries?
Yeah. Okay, we're going to fade you out, Mitchell.
The smell is gross, the way.
Is it stuck?
My goodness.
Jennifer, we should do a duet. I got it. Double. David, we're all playing against the computer.
Cameron, you're losing your legs.
That's right, Karen, right on film.
That's a anyway.
How come the tape isn't moving inside?
Yeah! It's gonna sparkle on us!
Alright, that thing's gonna go for about a minute.
Tommy!
Jennifer, you have to see this.
No,
it won't.
Get
on. Do it. Go ahead. I got you. Bend it. Turn it. You gotta hold me. I don't want to break my neck.
Push with your foot.
You're not gonna push me on it.
No,
wait a minute.
Push with your foot.
All right, now wait.
Get yourself,
no, let's do it this way. Okay, David. All right. All right. Help Grandma. Give Grandma just a very slight push. Forget it, Mitchell. I can do it better than
that. Well, easy, Mitch. I mean, David.
Now, looking at Mitchell, after he spiked a volleyball, made an ass out of himself, and sprained his ankle. Let me see you give us a demonstration, Mitchell, of your excellent work on crutches.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Okay.
We'll watch the foot first. Go ahead.
No. Oh, you do this again.
Okay. Now tell me, Mitchell, how did you do what you did?
Gosh, I spiked the ball over the volley net as awesome as I always do, and I fell down.
Exactly what did you fall on?
The gym floor.
And how do you feel at this moment?
Oh, great. So great. I could just walk on it.
Say hello to all the people. Say hello to yourself, Mitchell, watching this when you're over 20 years old. Say hello. This is so serious. Someday you'll be over 20 watching yourself. Okay. Go ahead. What do you have? What message do you have for yourself at age 20?
Okay, hello. And how are you doing?
You're going to talk to yourself in the future. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. Hello, awesome self. How are you doing? You are so awesome. you are now a millionaire, I see, and
what kind of a job do you have?
Hotel manager.
Oh, God. Goodbye.
Or garbage man. Whatever one's fine.
Bye! Bye!
Dad's playing Lemonade Stand.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
The
right.
What am I on the air for?
You're being lazy.
Oh.
Is Mitch on the camera?
Tell everybody how you feel about your brother hurting his ankle.
He's a jerk. I break my legs and everything, and I only hurt my knee before. He's always breaking thumbs and everything.
David, talk to yourself 20 years from now.
Huh?
I told Mitchell to talk to himself when he's 20. In other words, when you're 20 years old, you're going to see yourself on the tape. So what do you have to say to yourself when you're 20?
I don't know.
David, you're sitting here watching this and you're 20 and you're going to look at yourself when you were 10 and you're going
to
say, what kind of ding dong?
Let's see what I'm watching. You're the one that wants a boogie. I'm awesome, aren't I?
That's a shame. It's gonna take 2 pounds of bandwidth to get your smell out of it.
Smile, you're on candid camera.
Oh, for goodness sake.
She's taking more.
Oh, hi.
90-10 deal.
Huh?
He said, boy, that got a rise out of nowhere.
Come back, and then
thank you.
You did come back.
This is our old lady.
It brought our old time back.
Got to believe
you had to come back.
We lived with him for 16 years.
When you were first married?
Hi, Al.
No.
How are you doing? Oh, pretty good. I'll be up in a minute. I can't sit there too long.
Hi, Al.
I'm going by.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Okay. How you doing?
All right.
Evelyn.
What chair do you want? Let him sit in that one. You want me to open this? Let him sit there. I get up. Sit in that one. Got a pillow?
Wait a minute, I did.
I want to wait on it.
The last 5 years I had to open the mouth.
Now you can open it.
Maybe I did. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Don't save the paper.
Whoops.
No, don't fit.
Just cover your fingers. You can even break the ribbon.
I know it is.
Look at it.
She's so smart.
No, it's not. You're not getting it.
Get out of
here. It's not here.
We decided where she's in.
No,
it's not here.
You're getting one.
You told me it was mine.
No, sir.
We wanted to get it so we could all have one.
I'll have another one, maybe.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Leslie, get out of the way. That's the family picture.
Out of
the way, Jim.
When was it
taken?
No,
the day before Easter.
4 or 5 weeks ago.
Day before Easter.
Great.
Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, that's all nice.
How did he ever get everybody to smile?
Hey, no problem.
And all at the same time,
we're all smiling. That's beautiful.
Why don't you show it into the camera by the front door?
I didn't want to yell.
Some people are going
to do it. Oh, the speaker.
Yeah. Come on, good, huh? Very nice.
Are you ready?
Oh, God.
Oh, get out of here, Cal.
How you doing?
That's really nice. Oh, good. God bless you.
Nice to see you.
I know, you're holding up to the
camera.
They want to take a picture of it.
Don't hang your face.
Oh, that's nice.
instructions. Everybody wants to see it.
I couldn't get her attention.
I had my marriage vows, but this girl here.
Salad. How you doing? Looking good? Really?